Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics, and today we will see what is self-inductance and the mutual inductance in the electrical circuit. So first we will understand the concept of self-inductance and the mutual inductance, and then we will derive the expression for the self and the mutual inductance. So let's first see the inductance. So it is the property of an electric conductor by which the rate of change of current produces the electromotive force or a EMF. So let us say we have one coil and the current I is flowing through this coil. So the rate of change of current through this coil produces the EMF or a voltage. Now if this electromotive force or a voltage is produced within that same coil, then that is called a self-inductance. And if the rate of change of current produces the EMF or a voltage in nearby coil, then that is called a mutual inductance. So let's understand first a self-inductance. So as we have said earlier, the voltage or EMF that is generated is proportional to the rate of change of current. So we can write V is equal to minus L di by dt, where L is a self-inductance or a simply inductance, and the unit of this self-inductance or inductance is a Henry. So here you will observe a negative sign, and this negative sign is because of the Lenz law. So according to the Lenz law, the generated EMF or a voltage opposes the rate of change of current through which it is been generated. So here this negative sign implies that voltage that generated opposes the rate of change of current. So let us say this is the equation number 1. So now let us find the expression for this inductance in terms of magnetic flux. So let us say we have one coil, and in this coil the current I is flowing. So because of the flow of current, there will be a generation of a magnetic flux phi. And if the current that is flowing through this coil is varying with time, or we can say that the current that is flowing through this coil is time varying, then the magnetic flux that will be generated will be also be a time varying. So this time varying magnetic flux produces the EMF or a voltage in this coil. So according to the Faraday's law, the voltage that is induced in this coil can be given as V is equal to minus N d phi by dt, where N is the number of turns in this coil. So let us say this is the equation number 2. So here we got the two equations. So now let's just compare these two equations. So we can write minus L di by dt is equal to minus N d phi by dt. Or we can write L di is equal to N into d phi. That means L into I is equal to N into phi. Now here this N into phi, also known as a flux linkage or a magnetic flux linkage, and sometime it is also denoted by a symbol psi. So we can write L is equal to N phi divided by I, or psi divided by I. So this is the expression for inductance in terms of magnetic flux and the current. So now let us see the mutual inductance. So let us say here we have a two coils 1 and 2. And the number of turns in these coils are N1 and N2 respectively. Now let's say the current I1 is flowing through this coil number 1. And because of the flow of this current, there is a generation of a magnetic flux. Let's say that is a phi1. Now this magnetic flux will link with this coil number 1 and 2. So let us say the phi11 is the flux that is linked with this coil number 1, and the phi12 is the flux that is linked with this coil number 2. So here the current that is flowing through this coil number 1 is time varying, that is it is varying with a time. So because of that, the flux that is linked with this coil number 2 will be also be a time varying. So this time varying magnetic field will generate a voltage in this coil number 2, and let us say that is a V2. So according to the Faraday's law, we can write V2 is equal to minus N2 d phi 12 divided by dt, where N2 is the number of turns in this coil number 2. Let us say this is the equation number 3. Now the voltage that is generated in this coil number 2 is proportional to the rate of change of current in the coil number 1. So we can write V2 is proportional to the rate of change of current in the coil number 1, That means V2 is equal to minus M di1 divided by dt, where M is nothing but a mutual inductance between these two coils. And here the negative sign implies that the voltage that is generated in the coil number 2 opposes the rate of change of current. The unit of this mutual inductance is same as the self-inductance, that is a Henry. So let us say this is the equation number 4. So now here we have got two equations 3 and 4. So now let's just find the value of this mutual inductance in terms of a magnetic flux. So we can write minus M di1 by dt is equal to minus N2 d12 divided by dt. Or we can write M into di1 is equal to N2 into d12. That means MI1 is equal to N2 into 512. So we can write M is equal to N2 512 divided by I1. So this is the expression for a mutual inductance when the current is flowing in the coil number 1. Similarly, if current is flowing in the coil number 2, and because of that, if the voltage is generated in the coil number 1, then the mutual inductance M can be given as N1 into Φ21 divided by I2, where Φ21 is the flux that is linked to the coil number 1 because of the current that is flowing in the coil number 2. So now we can write mutual inductance M is equal to N2 into Φ12 divided by I1 is equal to N1 into Φ21 divided by I2. So now here the coupling between the two coil defines the how well the flux that is linked to the another coil. If the coupling between the two coil is very good, then the flux that is linked to the another coil will be the good. Similarly, if the coupling between the two coil is bad, then the flux that is linked to the another coil will be the poor. So to define this coupling between the two coils, we use a term coefficient of coupling. That is the fraction of total flux that is linked to the another coil. And it is denoted by a symbol K. So let us say the Φ1 is the total flux that is generated because of the current that is flowing in the coil number 1. And out of this flux Φ1, the Φ12 is the flux that is linked to the coil number 2. And the ratio of this flux Φ12 divided by Φ1 is known as a coefficient of coupling. Similarly, if Φ2 is the total flux that is generated because of the current flowing in the coil number 2, and out of the total flux, if the flux Φ21 that is linked to the coil number 1, then the ratio of this Φ21 divided by Φ2 is known as a coefficient of coupling. So the value of this K is between the 0 and the 1. If value of K is 1, that means the coupling between the two coils is 100%. If the value of K is 0, then there is no coupling between the two coils. So now let's just find the relation between this coefficient of coupling and the mutual inductance. So earlier we had find this expression for the mutual inductance. So now let's just multiply these two equations. So we can write M square is equal to N1 into Φ21 divided by I2 into N2 into Φ12 divided by I1. So now let's just multiply and divide this term by a Φ1 and Φ2. And by rearranging the terms, we can write N1 into Φ1 divided by I1 into N2 into Φ2 divided by I2 into Φ21 divided by Φ2 into Φ12 divided by Φ1. So as we had seen earlier, the first two terms are nothing but the self-inductance of the coil 1 and 2, that is L1 and L2. And if you observe the last two terms, they are nothing but the coefficient of coupling, that is K. So we can write them as a K into K. That means M square is equal to nothing but K square into L1 into L2. That means M is equal to K under root L1 into L2. So this is the expression between the mutual inductance and the coefficient of coupling. So now let us just take a simple example and find the value of this coefficient of coupling K. So here we have given the value of this L1, L2 and the M. And we need to find the value of this coefficient of coupling. So we can write K is equal to M divided by under root L1 into L2. That is nothing but 0.05 divided by under root 0.1 into 0.1. That is equal to 0.05 divided by 0.1. So the value of coefficient of coupling K is equal to 0.5. So in this way, if we have given a value of self-inductance and mutual inductance, then we can find the value of this coefficient of coupling. Or in another way, if we have given a value of the self-inductance and the coefficient of coupling, then we can find the value of this mutual inductance. So I hope you understood what is self-inductance and the mutual inductance in the electrical circuit. If you have any question or suggestion, please let me know in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.